Thank you very much for inviting me. I would like to present a really recent project. First, I have to say that 2 years ago, I published this book. It's in French, Histoire naturelle de l'architecture, and it was like looking back to the history of architecture from a material point of view, and to say that maybe we have to learn from the past because we are developing an architecture that is depending of fossil energy, antibiotic, vaccine, but before 1950, it was completely different. The world was completely different. So maybe because we have this crisis today, the return of pandemic, the problem of energy, so it's, of course, the global warming, but it's, we can see with the Ukraine war, all the problem of to get the energy. So we have to think, oh, the people they live before that, before the question of before having a very easy energy and health coming from the modernity. So so it's interesting to look back because, you know, when I was a student, we learned about this project, and it was like a model of geometry, analogy, and a very cultural project from Andrea Palladio, an architect, an Italian architect from the Renaissance. And so the way we learn about this project was completely what we can say superstructural. It was coming from Claude Lévi-Strauss' structuralism idea. So we never talk about this building from a material point of view, energy point of view. We only talk about the image, what it means, what was the signification. But if you read Palladio, if you look to this building, you understand that it's a climatic machine in reality. It's based on climatic issue. For example, you know, this perfect form, like a square inside and this circle inside the square, you know, this four side of the house, where it was based on the season. Because Palladio explained, in the winter, you are looking for the sun, so go to the south. So you have to go to the south. In the summer, you are escaping from the sun. So go on the north side. So you will eat there. And the morning you go to the east, and the afternoon to the west. So the way to organize this house is based to climatic issue. And then he said also you have to align all the door and the window to let the wind going through the house to evacuate the heat, but also to evacuate the miasma, you know, the pollution of the air. So why is there is this symmetrical alignment of the door? And then there is a portico to avoid the light. We can see on the section, and there is this huge dome. And the dome was also a kind of it was an inspiration from the Pantheon. And the Pantheon, you know, it's the idea is to it's. A convective idea, you know, the hot air is going up, the cold air is going down, so you have to create a high ceiling to let the air moving up, and so this is why there is a hole at the top of the Pantheon to let the hot air going out of the building. And then it takes the cold air from the underground, and this comes from the middle of the room. You know, on these stones have some hole to let the cold air coming from the underground. So all this house is a climatic machine, but we never heard about that when I was a student. You know, it was, and so we have to learn back this kind of analysis. So now I would like to present two projects we made recently. One for was a competition. Anonymous competition in Lausanne for a university building. We get the third prize for this, and our building is a small square in the middle, and so we try to reduce the quantity of ground that we are using. And for the when it's not too warm and not too cold, we just open the window, and we use a little like a Palladio strategy of Coppola to let the hot air going out in the middle of the building. And during the winter, or during the heat wave, we can use another type of mechanical system to control the air. And now, we did the composition of the building. We start to compose a building as a kind of thermodynamic machine in between a cold pole down and a warm pole at the top of the building. And in between, we create a kind of ventilation duct that is not just a pipe, it's becoming the building itself that works like a big ventilation. And so for the cold pole, we took the inspiration from this is La Laiterie de Marie Antoinette, so it's a milk house for Marie Antoinette. And it was a room where she stored the milk. You know, it was a kind of natural fridge. And it was cooled by the fountain. There is a lot of evaporation. You know, when you have evaporation of water, it changes the change of phase from liquid to gas, reduce the temperature of the air. It was working also on inertia. During the night, you open the window and it cools the stone, and during the day, it keeps that. And there is no direct window, so everything is made for cooling the space and for keeping the milk at a fresh temperature. So we take this inspiration for creating an in the underground of the building. We have the chance to have underground water. So at 3 meters down, we have underground water. So what we propose is to open during the winter, the summer, we open the door for the underground water. So it go inside, it create a lake, underground lake. So it's cool all the building from the underground, and maybe, and then during the winter, of course, we are closing that, so we keep it dry. And we propose to have a system of ventilation, a little like a narguilé, a water pipe, you know. So the air arrive and it's cool in the underground, and then it move up. And by a natural aspiration from a sun tower, it suck the air, the new air, and it go to all the space. And so it's why there is a little this pyramidal form of the grid, you know, because it's trap all each floor, it trap the things. And then for the top of the building, we use another type of inspiration, you know, this greenhouse that create a very high warm space that will be very comfortable for the winter. So we have this kind of so we create this summer living room, if we want, in the basement, and a winter living room at the top of the building that there. So this is this kind of inspiration that we are looking back to this kind of old way of cooling and warming the building without using fossil energy or by limiting the use of the fossil energy. And then for the plan, we work on another type in the choice of the ground. We choose a ground linked to the emissivity and effusivity. So it means when there is a direction light during the winter, it touch the ground, and we store the heat of the ground inside the inertia of the ground, of the floor. So we choose stone, in the blue is stone. And then more we go in the interior of the space, more it become low effusivity material, so it become wood and wool in the center of the room where there is no direct sunlight. And then, so there is some other type of strategy in this there. And then we have this building, so all the construction is made in wood with a column, so each floor can be can have a any type of arrangement, of composition. And when we go to the top like that. And so we can see some, so this is the wood structure. This is so the ventilation system with a big duct, the blue duct, if we want, that it becoming the common space. And then on the periphery, there is where we take the exhaust air. And so this is an image of the interior with this kind of grid, like the Palladio grid we can find in the Villa Rotonda in the building. We also choose here, the handrail is in the copper. You know, this is killing the virus, you know, the COVID-19 stay only 5 minutes on the copper when he stay 24 or 48 hours on the stainless steel or plastic. So this is kind of return of choice of material that have a kind of more, less narrative meaning, but more physical meaning, and this is at the top of the building. And then a project we are working now, it's for industry. Sorry, there is not the I don't know if I have, but it, I will do it very quickly. This is an industrial and an office building in France. And so we are also working on a kind of polarity of with a warm pole and a cold pole that are in between. And in between we have the office and the industrial building. And so for the hot pole, we use the inspiration for the greenhouse. So we, during the winter, we will produce the hot air inside the greenhouse. So it will be all the ventilation air will come from the greenhouse, and then it's blow inside the down. It's the industrial production, and up it's office building. And so this is like that. So we have a geothermal warming, and then it's warm also in the greenhouse, and then it's blow inside the building. And then for the cold pole, so it will be this space will be this one will be like the winter living room, winter public space, and for the summer public space we do the opposite. We are creating a kind of grotto at the north of the building, where we will cool the air during the summer, so it will be cool, and then it's blow there, and it's cooled by inertia, by the fountain, by all the system for cooling. So this is this kind of. Okay. Thank you.